Ring of a matchup featuring the St. Louis Reign and the San Francisco Monsters. Hello there once again, everybody. My name is Jordan Smith, and tagging along with me tonight is the commissioner, at least one of the commissioners, of the Premier Simulation Basketball League, that being James Olson. James, how are we doing tonight?
Man, I'm doing great. It is time to see some PSB here tonight under the bright lights in San Francisco, and we got St. Louis Reign taking them on. It's going to be a barn burner.
Right now, a matchup here for the Reign, who are coming off of a big 99-73 victory over the Portland Rampage, the first game in team history and the first win in team history for the Reign. They're looking to build off of that here against a San Francisco Monster team who is getting their first action in Premier Simulation Basketball League history. As we get you set for the lineups here in just a little bit.
As Judge Mills Lane would say, let's get it on! Am I the only one that remembers Celebrity Deathmatch?
Tip one here by the Monsters, and we're underway. As Vintfeld sends it down the lane, goes turn around, no good. Right now, you see they're the win against Portland. As they start things off with a big three, a 55% field goal percentage against Portland. And they're starting off 100% right here, James.
Yeah, they can start off 100%, but we know down the line it's going to dwindle down. They got to really keep up the intensity if they want to be a winner in this game.
Big three to respond there for the Monsters. Basket made by Eaton Letterman. That gets things going. He's one of the two guys for the Monsters. Letterman and Vintfeld were the main focus for the Monsters. Another response, another three.
L.A. Rowe dialing up in the 415 back to the 314, baby. That's a three-point bomb, as Rainman would say.
Big dunk right there by Ragone.
Ragone is one of the top point guards in the PSB. He is a lot of talent. He's got a lot of athleticism, and right there, you got to see a grown man jam from a point guard.
Loose ball recovered. Here's a shot from three just off the front of the rim. Into the corner here. With it is Letterman at the top to reset. Outside Ragone on the far wing, 6 seconds on the shot clock. 1 point lead for the Reign. Here's Cook with it, he'll back up, step up for three off the front of the rim.
Ill-advised shot with a hand all up in your face. Don't do that again, young fellow.
San Francisco foul.
And a foul by Letterman, that'll be his first foul of the game. Roll the fourth. Here's a deep three. That one off the front of the rim. Had to beat the shot clock. As Bowers just had to launch it from way too far. Vintfeld with the slam.
Nice jam.
Makes it a 1 point lead for the Monsters.
Definitely worth the price of admission. Look at this 3 point. Oh!
Big three there from Rowe the fourth. Back and forth we go in this ballgame. 6 minutes left in the opening quarter as that one's deflected. Recovered by Vintfeld and then puts it back down with the slam as you take a look at the replay.
He stayed with that ball all the way from the offensive rebound, and he wanted to put a poster dunk to signify that he wanted that 2 points. Nice play right there.
And that one just off the mark here is here come the Monsters, tied at nine, 5.5 minutes left to go in the opening quarter. Looked like an alley-oop attempt, but may have been deflected and stolen. Bowers outside. Rowe not able to get that one to fall. Here comes Cook with it. As we give you the starting lineups for the Monsters, it'll be Tony Ragone. Tony Time is his main nickname. Eaton Letterman getting the call as well, followed by Dan Levin, Tyler Cook, and Nathaniel Vintfell. As that one had to be forced up with time winding down. No good on the shot there. Here are the starters for the St. Louis Reign. Going to be Jacoby Mamba. Is that one will fall for three. Basket made by L.A. Rowe, the fourth. And the Reign have the lead once again. I mentioned Rowe in the game, Bowers in the game, Mamba in the game. As well, you have a couple of younger guys making banks. And Justin McBride of St. Louis has called for the foul to be on Rowe. And some substitutions will be made here. B will check in. And for the Monsters, we'll get a substitution down low. Stewart will make his way into the ballgame.
Nice substitution, and definitely keep an eye out on Nita B.
Like I mentioned in the opening, James, this is the first game in team history for the Monsters. They started off fairly strong, but when you force up shots like that, you're not going to get much.
No, you won't.
Block there, out of bounds, a Reign keep possession, but a good job on the interior defense by Dan Levin. So a good block on the replay.
Levin stayed with that ball and went up and swatted that away. Welcome to the block party.
See the coaches for each side. Trying to get the early victories here in league play. As we're just winding down the first week of action here in the league. As that one will fall. Now a 5-point lead for the Reign. Already shooting at a clip of 50%, almost matching the 55 they got for the Reign in the win against Portland just this past week. As here's an outside three, that one falls for the Monsters.
Uno. Dos, tres, bomb.
Judah Mintz with the three-pointer, and it's a two-point ball game. Here's a response from outside. That one falls as well. David Kibba with the three-pointer to respond. It's back to a five-point lead for St. Louis.
Even if it is a five-point game, this is going to be one heck of a game.
Grant with it at the elbow. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Got to drive in. A little bit of contact. They'll call it on B. That'll be his first foul of the game. Some substitutions coming into the ballgame. Reed will make his first minutes of the ballgame for the Reign. And coming in for the Monsters, you see there will be Vassell. Vassell will get the inbound to start up play. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Stewart to the corner. Gets it on over. Bird with it. 8 feet. That one off the back of the rim, but a foul on Reed just as soon as he comes into the ballgame. As the two free throws coming up for Drake Bird.
Bird is one of those guys who just randomly signed with San Francisco to make a name for himself. And also making a name is the scoring breakdown. 3 points made, points off assists right now for St. Louis. Impeccable. Watch this later on.
First free throw off the front of the rim. That one won't go.
Free throws should be your best friend. You go to the line for two, possibly 3-point opportunities, and if you can't cash in on them, that's going to be costly down the line. He's got to make this one.
Bird again with the free throw. Won't go 0 for 2 on the trip. That's not the free throw trip you want to have. Especially if you're down, as that three will be missed wide open in transition. And here comes San Francisco. Bird up top for three. Easy money. 2-point difference now in the ball game to start early on, 2.5 minutes left to go in the opening quarter.
Still very early in this game, but both teams with a dogfight need to really step it up.
Swift, turnaround shot, that one off the back of the rim. A little strong in the shot there as Stewart gets the board. Takes it down the court. Vassell blocked out of bounds. Good job on the rejection there from Lorraine, specifically by Silas Swift, as he swiftly takes care of business there. Pun completely intended, James.
Oh, here he comes out with the puns. Is that actually water in your cup? Because I don't think it is.
A stolen on the interception there for the inbound. Looked like B on the receiving end of that one. So now here come the Rain with a chance to extend their lead.
2 minutes remaining in the first.
Three-pointer. That one goes. A little bit of a turnaround shot there by Kibba. But somehow it gets that one to rattle in. And it's a five-point game once again.
Kibba with a three-point bomb. The kids got Rain.
Stewart driving inside. Pump fakes a couple times. Now looks out for options. Mintz with it. Gives it on up. Here's Grant on the near wing. Drives inside. Floater won't go. Teardrop tries again and blocked from behind by Swift. But they'll call a shooting foul.
Shooting for San Francisco.
And so now Grant will head to the free throw line for two opportunities.
Last time at the line, they couldn't cash in. San Francisco definitely needs to cash in on these free throws now.
Take a break.
And we mentioned this is the
two shots.
First game in team history for the Monsters. The two main guys to watch for them, Eaton Letterman and Nathaniel Vintfeld. Those are the two guys that really watch as the first free throw falls, James.
Those two guys definitely are ones to watch out for, but you also have to look at Dan Levin. You also have to look at Tyler Cook. And, of course, Tony Time Ragone. Definitely a five that is, in my mind, going to be, well, I'd say it, monsters in this league.
Second free throw goes for Grant. Three-point ball game. Minute and a half left to go in the opening quarter of play. Kibba drives from the charity stripe, won't go. Stewart with the board. He'll have to back up. You see there the rebound differential. Usually when you're winning the rebound category, you're leading in the ball game, but not the case so far. Stewart off the back of the rim, offensive board. Vassell backs out of defender. 9 seconds, 8 seconds on the shot clock. Turn around. And kisses that one off the glass for two to make it a one-point ball game.
He stayed with that all the way. Vassell getting the offensive rebound. Turn around and put it down. Oh, yeah, 2 points for sure.
Swift turnaround again. Using a little separation with the late kick, but no go. Here comes Bird with it now as he gets the board. Ten seconds on the shot clock, driving in. Vassell not able to get that one to go. I think it was blocked from behind.
Where's Rain at when we need him? It's a block party up in here.
So a one-point lead for the Rain. Reed backs down a defender. 18 seconds left in the first quarter. Kisses it off the glass for two. Three-point lead for St. Louis as San Francisco, more than likely, will hold for the final shot of the quarter. Grant with it right now. On the near wing, 7 seconds, 6 seconds. We'll look to get in position more than likely for a three to tie it. Passes it off, Mintz for three. Buzzer beater as that one leaves it with 0.7 seconds left to go in the quarter. We head to the second, tied at 22. Here on the Premier Simulation Basketball Action right here on the Global Simulation Sports Network. Back here to start the second quarter of action. Jordan Smith alongside me is James Olsen. And James, what a great start to this ball game we've had so far.
Most definitely. Both teams coming out strong. It's tied at 22 after one. I mean, what else can you say for the people here tonight in the arena paid for one heck of a game? What else is going to happen?
Call a foul there.
Taking two shots.
Rowe the fourth will head to the free throw line.
L.A. Rowe the fourth, the St. Louis Rain prospect, definitely watching out for it. His last game against Portland went 13 points, and he had three behind the arc. This kid is going to be a big star, and tonight he's even showing his worth.
This free throw goes. You know, in taking a look at this Rain team, what they were able to do against the Rampage last week, Kibba led the scoring for each side, or excuse me, for the Rain, I should say, with 25 points in the game off 9 of 10 shooting, 7 of 8. Out of that 9 of 10 was from behind the three-point line. He's going to be a player really to watch for this season and for this team.
I clearly just said that. L.A. Rowe is going to be a threat in this league, and he's definitely putting on a clinic here and everywhere.
Block on the inside. Now here comes St. Louis with it. They've been doing this all game. Here comes Rowe the fourth. Gets that one in the contested lane. And it's a four-point game.
Rowe is doing his thing, baby. I'm telling you, he's going inside. He's getting his baskets. Again, top prospect.
Here's Ragone for three. Gets that one to fall.
Can I say it? Bang!
One-point ball game.
Oh, definitely. These teams are coming out strong here in the second quarter. They are keeping up the intensity through and through. Oh, man.
Missed shot there. There come the Monsters of it, trying to take the lead. They're going at the top. Everybody just kind of standing still, waiting for something to start up. Here's Ventfall for three. That one goes. San Francisco with the lead.
Did you see his range on that one? He shot it from the arena logo.
Well, the four drives it in and dunks it over a couple of Monsters with the monster dunk of his own. Already there were 15 points in the ball game, and he is starting out strong for this Rain squad.
He went up and away on that one, Jordan. Definitely wanted to touch the top of the sky, and he threw it down.
And a foul called. Banks will be called for the foul. It'll be his first of the game.
At the line for San Francisco, number 8. At the line for 2.
Ventfeld will head to the free throw line.
Ventfeld is definitely one of the big prospects here for San Francisco. He was a top pick by this team, and he is going to show out for this San Francisco squad. Definitely keep your eyes on him.
First free throw up and in for Ventfeld. It'll make it a one-point lead for the Monsters. That one goes as well. And it's now a two-point lead for San Francisco. I believe this is their largest of the ball game, if not one of the largest margins of the lead so far for them. St. Louis misses a shot. San Francisco trying to extend their lead. You see there, they lead the rebound category 16-7. And like I was trying to say earlier, usually if you're leading the rebound total, you're leading in the ball game. Wasn't like that earlier, but it is now, as there's a second attempt at an alley-oop that goes away. All right, excuse me.
You have to stop with the showtime. Stop it now.
Mamba into McBride. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Trying to back down a defender. Here's Rowe from the top. Off the mark. Ventfeld with the board as he'll take it across the timeline.
These guys are cleaning up the glass here tonight. The Monsters definitely want to get that sponsorship. I think I said Windex was on line one.
7 seconds on the shot clock. Ragone one-on-one still trying to dribble the air out of the basketball. Here's that one from the free throw line. Makes that one fall. And it's a four-point lead here for San Francisco. Officially their largest lead here so far in this one.
Go back to that last play. He had handles. He wanted to show a crossover to these fans here in San Francisco.
A foul on the three-pointer goes.
First team foul.
And already.
Number 20, 3 points.
Well, I was going to say that would have been. Looks like they counted the three-pointer, but it was an offensive foul on Banks. So, San Francisco gets the basket. They'll try for a three, and that'll take it back to a four-point lead.
He answered back.
Tyler Cook with the three-pointer, and it's 35-31. Inside, almost open lane. Here's Bowers again, fouling the shot. In and one, as Cook is called for the foul. And so now Bowers will have a chance for a three-point play, the old-fashioned way to bring it back to within 1 point.
Notice what he did there, and that is what's been going on throughout the whole game. Both teams are cleaning up the offensive glass, and they're putting down the points to come off of it. It's so crazy that these guys are staying this aggressive.
Saw right there on the stat line, 7 points off of turnovers. Or 23 points off of turnovers, 7 off the bench. And that is a stat that is really going to help you win ball games, is scoring off turnovers, as that one will be off the mark by Vintfeld. Just under 5 minutes left to go in the first half. Still a one-point lead for the Monsters. Mamba with it at the top. Rowe from just inside the three-point line off the mark. Here's Cook now. So he gets the board. He'll take it across the timeline. Gives it to Ragone a little bit ahead. Loses the ball. Gets it right back to the Monsters. 13 seconds on the shot clock. Ragone at the top. Gets it to Vintfeld. A couple feet behind the three-point line. In and out. Bowers with the board.
They are not hitting their shots. San Francisco needs to slow it down just a little bit more and try to find something that'll actually work in their favor right now.
McBride won't go on the three-point attempt. Here come the Monsters. Letterman to the corner. They're going back up top. 4 minutes left to go in the first half. 8 seconds, 7 seconds. Here's Cook off the mark.
See, they are just forcing something up right now with a hand all up in their face. San Francisco, what are you doing? The fans, luckily, are not booing you out of the building right now.
Mamba with it. Row the fourth. Baseline won't go. Here's Levin with the board. You know, and taking a look at the map there, see the basket there, timeout called. James, this league is kind of spread out a little bit. You see there, most of the team centered on the East Coast.
I mean, the East Coast loves their basketball, but it's not saying right now. I might be working up some deals to cook up expansion.
Back out of the timeout, 3:21 left to go in the first half of play. 3-point lead for the Monsters. Jordan Smith alongside me is James Olson. Back here on the Global Simulation Sports Network YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe. And as long as we get to 50 subscribers, and we'll have our first goal, as that one will go and tie it up at 37. After that, the next goal, 100 subscribers, so definitely don't forget to subscribe. And tell all your friends and family about it and get them to subscribe as well. Here's Grant on the inside, won't go. Swift with the rebound. From way up top, there's Reed from the baseline for three. A huge cross-court pass there to give the Rain the lead for the first time in what felt like a little bit of time here, James.
I mean, the Rain kind of were on a downward slope. They can build it back up even with a foul right now coming their way. The Rain will heat it up. We saw it against Portland, how they can just click on all cylinders. Right now, they're not clicking, but I guarantee they will be very soon.
Drive inside. That one looks like it was rejected and sent into the seats. The Monsters will keep possession here as the shot clock stops at 7 seconds.
I mean, this is not baseball here, but that fan was treating that like a foul ball. Wanted to take the souvenir home.
Stewart inbound to Grant. 5 seconds, 4 seconds, and gotta get a shot off here. Grant mid-range, in and out.
Ill-advised shot with a hand in your face.
Switz with the rebound. Outside, Kibba, got it.
Kibba is a deadly young man.
6-point lead for the Rain.
Definitely the Rain are clicking on the cylinders I was just talking about. Keep it up.
Stewart gets rejected as it goes out of bounds. Swift getting another rejection there. He is a guy to watch for this Rain squad. Has mainly been the guy who has taken care of business down low. and is really impressed. Even talking about what he did in the last game, he tied Bowers with 8 rebounds in the ball game. Even came up with 7 assists as well, the team high in that win against Portland.
And you have to think about it. He wasn't even drafted. Crazy stat to think about.
Inside, Holland with the jam and one. Off the laser pass from the outside, Vassell is called for the foul. And now a chance at a 3-point play the old-fashioned way for Ronald Holland.
Jordan, let me explain that play one time to you. He went inside. He wanted a purpose of throwing it down over his man. Wanted the Kodak moment to send back home to his family and say, hey, put this in a picture frame right next to my jersey. I made it happen, mama.
Free throw goes to make it a 3-point play. 46-39 the score. 1:25 left to go in the first half. Grant misses. Vassell with the board and the jam.
Did I not stake this earlier? If you clean up the glass and go with the second chance points, it's going to go in your favor. And the Monsters did it again.
Holland turnaround off the glass won't go. Nearly every single Monster in the lane there to try to grab the rebound.
I mean, they definitely want to hit, you know, get that that Windex sponsorship I was just talking about. Cleaning up the glass. Ooh, baby.
Inside, Vassell gets the basket to fall. One possession game with 46 seconds left in the first half.
Definitely check out this stat line right here. Points in the paint. Both teams putting up double-digit figures, and a lot of it coming off of what? Offensive rebounds.
And that one goes out of bounds. Monsters will get possession. A little bit, maybe an air ball there. 35 seconds left to go in the first half. Monsters looking for one more shot. A 3-pointer would tie it.
They could definitely work it into their favor, Jordan. They just have to play it smart. Make it or break it on this possession.
Bird goes in. Now Vassell outside. 7 seconds on the shot clock. That one looked like he was blocked, and now the shot clock turns off. 11 seconds left to go in the half. Doesn't matter. They don't need it. 3-pointer. 6-point lead for the Rain heading into the half. Here's Bird and the Monsters with a chance to try to even that up a little bit. Off the back of the rim, won't go. Swift will hold on to it. That'll do it for the first half. 49-43, the Rain of St. Louis ahead of the Monsters of San Francisco as we head into the halftime locker room. Back after this on the Global Simulation Sports Network. Back here to start the second half of play. Jordan Smith alongside me is James Olsen. 49-43. Rain ahead of the Monsters. And James, what did we see out of that first half action?
Both teams wound up putting up good performances in the first half. However, the biggest stat has got to be the offensive rebounds to the second chance points. Both teams have been hitting their stride on that statistic.
We're going with it. Gets it to Letterman. Back up top to Cook. 4 seconds inside, intercepted by McBride as he jumped about 3 feet in the air. Here's Bowers for 3, got it.
Ooh, what a 3-point bomb right there.
9-point lead for the St. Louis Rain, and you see there they've made 5 more from deep than the Monsters have all game. Inside, Letterman contact on the shot, won't go. McBride called for the foul. 2 free throws coming up here. At least it should be for the Monsters. Yes, it will be.
Now, what I noticed right there from Letterman is the fact that he wanted to throw it down not only on one of the St. Louis players, but he would have had the opportunity to throw it on 2 of the St. Louis players. However, the contact stopped him, and that is why he's going to line for the free throws. And of course, he actually hits his first one, which brings it just a little bit closer.
First free throw goes. second one goes as well. 52-45 the score. And a 2-for-2 trip from Letterman. Rain still ahead, though, as they try to extend this lead. They'll hold on to the ball as long as they can.
Now watch the screen right here.
There's Mamba. Got it from mid-range.
I told you.
9-point game once again.
Now, St. Louis has got this nice, comfortable lead. San Francisco needs to answer back in a strong way. And Benfield, oh my God, he knew what I was thinking.
A dunk there for Vintfeld. 54-47 is that one. We'll rattle out. 11 with the board. He'll take it cross court. Letterman in the corner. He'll try to drive the lane. Pump fake. Good pump fake there. Didn't go for the shot. Instead went to Levin. Deflected. Vintfeld. No go. McBride with the rebound. Best base offense here for the Rain. Takes it around now. Let's see offense reset. Inside. Deflected. And out of bounds. Some fast pace action here in the last couple of minutes.
You are right. There has been a lot of fast pace action. And obviously the blocks have been coming in that fast pace action. Check out that one right there by Bowers. Bowers definitely one of the guys for this St. Louis team who can do his thing on the offensive line, but also do it on the defensive line as well for St. Louis.
Thought I heard a deflection there. Maybe not, though. We're going with it. A missed shot from the Rain. 7-point ball game, 6:40 left to go, and counting in the third. Cook. Almost. Here comes Bowers with it. Inside, off the dunk. Nice entry pass there from McBride. Makes it a 9-point game once again.
Jamari Bowers went up, 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 and away. And he threw it on down with authority.
We're going. Contact and a shot coming up here.
Third personal foul, second team foul.
And now two free throws coming up.
Jordan, you all right over there, man? Your mic's starting to act up a little weird. But hey, you know what? Take your time. Get your stuff situated. I'm going to talk about the Global Simulation Sports Network during this whole little break that you got going on. GSSN definitely is putting on a clinic, bringing you the PSB action, as well as they'll be bringing more content very soon in the near future. You better go like, share, subscribe, comment, all of their stuff. You definitely cannot miss on out of what this company is gonna bring to you. Again, GSN is paving the way for simulation sports through and through. Salutations, my friend.
There it goes. It's now a 56-49 contest. Here in this one as Bowers takes it down the court. Mamba from the baseline. That one won't go. Now here come the Monsters. Baseline shot will fall from mid-range.
And that is a very nice shot right there. And check out the field goals on your screen.
You see there the shot difference when it comes to field goal shots so far in the ball game.
Second personal foul, first team foul.
So there the foul being called. Shot for three, that one goes.
I mean, another 3-point bomb by St. Louis, and they are definitely in the lead because of that.
Alley-oop this time, it works for the Monsters.
Number 18.
6-point ball game here in this one. Here's Rowe the fourth with it from the base, from the free throw line, excuse me, as he makes that one to make it an 8-point contest. Already 23 points tonight for Rowe the fourth, and he has had himself a very good night of basketball. Vintfeld in and out.
Rain are definitely building a strong lead halfway through this third.
Alley-oop won't go. It'll go out of bounds. It deflected off the Monsters. And it'll stay with St. Louis. You know, something to note, James, about what the Rain were able to do successfully in the last game against the Rampage. Yes, they committed turnovers as a three-pointer goes there. But a main thing for them, nobody committed more than one turnover the entire ball game. If you committed a turnover, it was only one. Granted, it was about 8 or 9 different players. But the fact of the matter is, nobody committed more than one turnover. So Cook goes for three, and that one doesn't go. Bowers with the rebound. But that's something, James, that is really, really big when it comes to having success in this league. Rain with the big three.
You know, I'm going to touch upon that. Definitely, for sure, the possessions that you can hold on to will favor you down the line. And having only one turnover that whole game, of course, that's going to definitely give you the dub any given night.
Letterman, three-pointer. Number 10. The Rain have made it a big lead, but the Monsters are trying to stay within it here. At least trying to give themselves a chance. They're still down by 11. Banks tries to make it 14, and he dies with the three-pointer.
Where is the defense on that one, Jordan? They are nowhere to be found.
Timeout taken by San Francisco.
Monsters definitely need this timeout to regroup.
Still have what looks like 6 remaining here as we take a quick break. 70-56 right ahead on the Global Simulation Sports Network. Back here in San Francisco, Jordan Smith alongside me is James Olson. And James, the Rain have really taken advantage here and have slowly built themselves a 14-point lead here with 3:29 left to go in the third.
Remember, I said that if they clicked on all cylinders, they would return to the same status they did against Portland. And right now, they have clicked on all cylinders, a 14-point lead. Luckily, it's not up to a 30-point lead at this point.
Intercepted once again. The Rain have done it once. They'll do it twice, and they'll finish it with a two-handed jam.
Holland wanted to put on a highlight reel. He could have thrown down a windmill or a 360, but instead, he just went with the two-hand.
Here's Stewart driving inside. That one deflected. He'll get his own rebound, though, off the block. Shot clock doesn't reset, though, so Bird will back up, shoot for three. Got it. Rattles in, 72-59. Monsters trying to get back into this thing.
He originally saw that he could have drove, but then found the wide open three, and he made him pay.
Here's Kibble with it. He'll slam it in. A 15-point lead for the Rain.
Kibble doing his thing here tonight like he did last time against Portland. Definitely a spark off the bench.
Bird on the baseline tries to drive inside. Now gives it to Mintz. Alley-oop, Vassell with the slam.
Vassell answers back with a, anything you can do, I can do better.
74-61, 13-point game, and a foul is called on Grant. That'll be his first of the game, team's second of the half. And the Rain will inbound it.
Rain are definitely trying to keep this lead. However, San Francisco slowly creeping back into this game.
B with it on the wing, now gives it to Swift, 8 seconds on the shot clock. From the elbow, deflected, stolen, and backcourt violation is called on the Rain here. You saw him there, Swift was trying to say that shouldn't have been backcourt, but it was called. Looks pretty obvious. So now with 2 minutes left to go in the third quarter, Monsters will have a chance to try to make this a 10-point ball game should they get the three. There's the three.
Splish splash, he was taking a bath.
Mintz to bring it back to 10, 74-64. Now with 1:45 into the third, alley-oop won't go. Banks gets it off the deflection and steps back for the mid-range jumper. They're hitting right at about that same point they were with the Rampage. Got to win while shooting 55% from the field. So far, the Rain shooting 57% as Reed is called for his second foul with the reach in. That'll stay on the floor as time is called. Substitutions are made. Mamba and Bowers check in for St. Louis. In San Francisco, three substitutions of their own. Ragon, Lederman, and it looks like Cook as well.
Cook is back in, and the starters are all back in pretty much. This is where it needs to be crunch time for San Francisco to stay in this game.
Here's Ragon with it. Cook off the mark on the three-pointer. Rebound by Banks. 12-point lead for St. Louis. They could try to start pulling away even more here. They need a quick run in the next 65 seconds. Mamba with it. 7 seconds now on the shot clock. Pass to number assist. 20.
Assist from number 24.
Three-pointer made on that one from L.A. Rowe the fourth. The point guard getting it done today. Pretty sure he's around 30 points now in this one. And 78 now to 66 as Bittenfeld gets the jumper from about 7 feet. See, there's a drastic improvement for the Monsters, but it still hasn't been enough here in the third. They're finally, for the first time in this game, shooting over 50% from the field.
The offense is clicking. Now where's the defense?
Read outside to Banks. Got it. Banks. Banks hits the three to make it 81 to 66. And something about Banks, too, in that last game against Portland, he came out blazing with 3 blocks in that game, led the team in blocks in that ball game. As there's the big three to make it 81 to a nice 69 for the Monsters. Shot clock turned off. 12 seconds left to go in the quarter. A three won't go. Rebound by Cook. He'll take it down the court. Wouldn't be surprised if he took the last shot. Never mind. Here comes Ragon with it. Back to Cook. Here's to the baseline. Vintfeld won't go off the rim, and that'll do it for the third. 81-69 the score. St. Louis pulling away here in this one. As we take a quick break, back for the fourth after this here on the Global Simulation Sports Network. Start of the fourth quarter, and St. Louis will look to build on and finish off the win here. 81-69 the score. Jordan Smith here alongside me is James Olsen. And really, for the rain, they just got to keep doing what they've been doing in the game, and there's a shot right there to do just that. 8:39 and counting left to go. And it's now a 14-point lead for St. Louis. Really, they just got to make sure they stop San Francisco. They'll take care of business here, as that one will be a foul. Looks like on Macon Banks.
Taking 2 shots.
So now Vintfeld will head to the charity stripe for 2.
Not trying to take away from Vintfeld going to the line right now, but let's look at the statistic that was just back on the screen. The Rain have 6 steals, and they have 17 points coming off of that. That is huge in this game. You get a steal, you bring it back down the court, it's definitely going to go in your favor. Now, you look at the free throws in this game, this is where it's very crucial as well. Both teams pretty much hitting their free throws. However, the Rain have hit a little bit more in the favor of percentage-wise. The Monsters have been to the line more in this game.
Over 2 on the trip, 83-71. The score here, a 12-point lead. Monsters trying to stay within it and trying to claw back in it. But every opportunity they've had here in the last 12 or so minutes of the ball game, the Rain have responded right back. And as I say that, there's another basket right there.
And they have just been clicking on their stride. This is why they have a lead. This is why they are actually doing what they need to do. And that's try to win ball games.
At the mark offensive board won't go by Vintfeld. Maybe a little bit of contact. Either way, here come the Rain as there's some contact. That's called. Ragon called for the foul. Coach is happy with that. Not really sure whether or not he's happy, not happy with Ragon, or not happy at the potential foul call on the other side. But either way,
take a break.
We'll see Banks head to the free throw line for 2.
I mean, if you were the head coach, would you be happy that you're down by 14 and one of your star players just followed a very good player that's coming off the bench. Actually, it's not making banks coming off the bench, but the point is right now is you're down big right now in front of your home team, your home crowd, on your home opener. Again, would you be happy, Jordan? Because I clearly would not be happy if I was that coach right now.
Second free throw falls, 87-71. Rain ahead here with 7:45 and counting. We'll have to go in the ball game, and if the Monsters can't get some stops here, this one may be almost all but done. That one will go. Levin gets the basket from the free throw line. 87-73 the score. There's Rowe. Got the three.
They've been doing this all night.
Are we surprised at this point? Or just purely entertained?
I mean, I'm entertained. I don't know about the fans, but this is what is expected from St. Louis.
Letterman found the shot. Two free throws coming up. Banks called for the foul, his fifth now of the ball game. If this was a much closer ball game, it would probably matter a little bit more. But as of right now, five fouls, yes, is a lot no matter what. But the fact of the matter is, there is a 17-point difference in this ball game right now. Five fouls, probably a little too aggressive for at this point in the ball game. But still, it's not hurting you on the scoreboard.
No, it's not hurting you on the scoreboard. However, your coach is going to ask you at the end of this game, why did you pick up this many fouls? Five right now, with a lot of time still left in the fourth, you could still have a potential of fouling out, and that would not help.
Two for two on the trip. 15-point difference here in San Francisco.
Right now, the Monsters need to get back into this game and stop the St. Louis Reign from scoring. Plain and simple.
San Francisco more than likely just trying to recover.
Number 20.
Whatever they lost at this point in the ball game. See there, Rowe with 33 points now, 71% shooting. That, I think, is the biggest difference. He's made on average as Ragone gets a big dunk there. Put a little life in this crowd. See the row, 12 of 17, 71% from the field. That is huge. Anytime you can get somebody to shoot 70% with that many shots on your team's going to have a very good night. As that one goes there for Bowers. He now has 15 points. Bowers in the last game, 11 points against the Rampage.
Look at the statistics that just popped up for both Rowe and Bowers. They are completely decimating the opposition in this game.
Rowe, now with 36 in the ball game.
He can't be stopped at this point.
He might be the first player, if I'm not mistaken. If he keeps this up, he might be the first player in league history to get to 40 points.
I mean, 40 would be a big thing to hit. Nobody's hit that plateau so far in this league, but it's still very early on in the PSB season. I wouldn't be surprised.
Off the mark. The slam from Letterman. One-handed power jam. 97-79, just over 5 minutes. Let's go on this one. There's the basket to make it 38 now in the ball game. 5 points for mid-range.
L.A. Rowe is doing his thing, but let's go back to the previous play before that. Letterman wanted to make an authority statement, and he did.
One more basket, and Rain has eclipsed Rowe has eclipsed the 40-point mark. One more basket, and the Rain will have eclipsed 100 points. Here's McBride. Got the three. There's the hundo. Yeah, this one pretty much all but said and done with 4.5 minutes left to go. San Francisco absolutely has been silenced here tonight as Vinfeld will get the three to put a little bit of energy back into the crowd. 20-point ball game. Now at this point, let's just get Rowe the fourth, his 40-point game. first, though, Flat Bowers hit a three.
Bowers has definitely did his thing here tonight as well. Do not stride away from his performance.
Dunk on the other side. There's this high-intensity action going back and forth here. Now, we saw it a little bit earlier in the ball game, and now we're seeing it towards the end when the game doesn't even matter at this point.
I mean, this is too little, too late. This should have been done at least the last quarter or last half. Right now, I mean, San Francisco is just trying to make something at least presentable on their part in this game.
Number 23. Bowers gets that one to go.
San Francisco.
The timeout call by the Monsters. Just want to talk things over right quick. 107-84 the score, 3:42 left to go on the blonde. St. Louis well on their way to a 2-0 start to the season. L.A. Rowe, the fourth, has been on fire tonight. 38 points for him so far. Easily the MVP of the ball game here as you get a good shot of him. He needs one more to get to 40. And if I'm not mistaken, James, with that, he would be the first 40-point scorer in league history.
Yes, he would definitely be the first
for a single game
to do it. Yeah, you're right. He's definitely on his pace for it there. But again, the Monsters need to actually close in on the defense. They might still have a chance to stop him from hitting that plateau.
Big dunk by Letterman. He has 16 now. Mamba, you see there, a point and an assist away from the double-double. Here's Bowers, pump fakes. Here's Rowe outside. 10 seconds on the shot clock. He'll go baseline. Pass outside to Mamba. Missed the shot.
Mamba had the opportunity to at least put a name for himself in this game. Right now, it's not clicking in his favor.
Cook from the baseline. Corner three. Just under 3 minutes left to go in this one. Now here's Mamba with it. Rowe drives inside, and that one sent away out of bounds. St. Louis keeps possession, but a huge block by Vintfeld. He said, "You're not making history on me. You're going to have to wait to get it on somebody else."
Yeah, who?
7:89 the score. Outside Mamba. Here's to Bowers now. He tried to drive inside from the free throw line. That one misses. Vintfeld grabbed it as soon as it came off the rim. Now here's Letterman. Just trying to end on a couple of good positive possessions here. Here's Cook from the wing. Got that one to fall. Good sign there.
Very good sign.
Now a 15-point game. Get another stop or two and a couple more threes. This game has changed completely. Mamba. Rowe, basket, won't go in. Here's Vintfeld on over to Levin. 2 minutes left. Need another three, and this game may change just a little bit here. We gotta start doing it quick here with less than 2 minutes. Cook from 17, that one falls. 13-point game, ladies and gentlemen.
Now here comes the full court defense. Jeez, wow.
48 left to go, four court press by San Francisco. Comes Mamba with it. Back and forth between him and McBride, and the slam by Mamba.
Assist goes to McBride.
That may have been it, but we'll see what happens here, and we'll see how quickly San Francisco can respond. Letterman at the top, tries to drive. Floater won't go. Bowers with the rebound, and that may just do it.
I agree to your point right there, Jordan.
Less than 120 left to go here in the ball game. Banks for three. Got it to fall, and that one is all she wrote. San Francisco making a little noise at the end, but just not able to get the baskets and a couple of more stops that they needed. As now subs will come to the bench, or excuse me, to the scores table for both sides. As that one misses. Now here comes Rowe with it. Less than a minute left to go. Can he get the all-important basket to get to 40? Passes it to Mamba, to McBride. Turnaround blocked. Here comes Vintfeld with it. 35 seconds left to go in this one. More than likely the final possession for San Francisco. Tries to drive it in. Rainbow shot off the back of the rim. Won't go. Rebound is ultimately made by Banks. Here's Mamba with it. He'll try to drive. Kicks it outside to Banks. Rowe with it. More than likely hold on for the final shot. Cheesy, now Rowe has it. Double teamed outside. Three-pointer.
Number 24.
Jacoby Mamba with the three to fall. And that'll do it for this one. 115-94, the final score. The Reign go to 2-0 on the season. The Monsters suffer their first loss in their first game in team history.
We'd like to thank everyone for coming out and supporting
and James,
your team.
What did you see from this one?
I mean, I literally saw a complete domination for the Reign.
That'll do it for us here on the Global Simulation Sports Network. I want to thank my partner, James Olson, for joining us today. On the call for this one, I'm Jordan Smith saying good evening, good night, and we'll see you next time right here on the Global Simulation Sports Network.